So in the last video lecture, we have just learned about the two functions of management, that is planning and organizing. Now the next function of management, that is staffing. Staffing is the managerial function of recruitment, selection, training, developing, promoting and compensation of persons. That means staffing is organizing a particular staff for a particular work in the organization. That all staffing includes the managerial functions such as recruitment, selection, training of the persons, developing their skills, promotion according to their work and compensation according to the work of the persons. Staffing may be defined as the process of hiring and developing the required persons to fill in the various positions in the organization. This staffing involves the recruitment of various persons in the industries or the organization. So, the staffing is all about the persons working in the organization. The functions of staffing. The first and the foremost function of the staffing is to obtain the qualified persons for different job positions in the organization. In the staffing, the right person is recruited for the right jobs. Therefore, it leads to the maximum productivity and higher performance. It helps in promoting the optimum utilization of human resource through the various aspects. Job satisfaction and morale of the workers increases through the recruitment of the right person. Staffing helps to ensure better utilization of human resources, and it ensures the continuity and the growth of organization through developing the managers. So these are the all functions of management, which includes the selection of the right person on the right position, then developing their skills, then using their skills, utilizing the human resources, and the job satisfaction and moral support for the workers through the right recruitment of the right person. So this results in the growth of organization through the development of the managers working in the organization. So this is the whole cycle of the staffing process. First step in the cycle, that is the recruitment. Means what? The persons are recruited for the required job in the organization. Then the recruitment process, it is carried out, and from that recruitment process, a proper person is selected for the job profile. Then that proper person is orientation, its orientation and placement is done. Then after that orientation and placement, the training and development of that person is carried out in the training period of 1 or 2 months. Then that trained person is now remunerated for the proper remuneration according to his abilities. Then after that, his performance is evaluated throughout the working period, and according to that performance, he is promoted or the transferred to the next work. Now the next function of management, that is directing. The directing function is concerned with leadership, communication, motivation and supervision so that the employees perform their activities in the most efficient manner possible in order to achieve the desired goals. This directing function is all concerned about the leadership qualities, the communication qualities, motivation of the persons working in the organization and supervising all the persons working in the organization, so that the employees working in the organization can perform their activities in the well-defined manner and which will help us to achieve the desired goals. The leadership element involves issuing of instructions and guiding the subordinates about the procedures and the methods. The leadership quality includes the giving instructions to the worker working in the organization and guiding our subordinates about the procedure and the various methods which are followed in the organization. The communication must be open both ways so that the information can be passed on the subordinates and the feedback received from them. The communication is the most important part in the organization's growth. The communication should be in between the two ways, in the managers to the employee and from the employee to the managers, so that the feedbacks can be received from the peoples, and with that feedback we can plan for our next future plannings. Motivation is the very important. Since highly motivated people show the excellent performance with the less direction from. So the motivation is the most important part, because if we motivate the people working in the organization, they will show their excellent working in the organization, the excellent performance they can give, and from that performance or from that excellency, with the less direction, we can grow our organization. Supervising subordinates would be lead in continuous progress reports, as well as assure the supervisors that the directions are being properly carried out. Supervising means at the time of working, we have to evaluate each and every people as they are working properly or not. This supervising with the subordinates, this leads to the continuous progress report, as well as assures the supervisor that the directions are being properly carried out. Then, the importance of directing. The directing is important because direction initiates the actions, direction integrates the employee's efforts, direction attempts to get the maximum out of the individuals, direction facilitates changes in the organization, and direction provides a stability and balance in the organization. So that's why the directing function is the important function in the management, in which we are directing the peoples working in the organizations. So direction, with the help of direction, we can initiate our actions. We can give the instructions to the peoples working in the industry or organization. With the help of direction, we can integrate the employees' efforts. Means how the employees are working, according to that we can give the remuneration to the peoples. Direction attempts to the get maximum out of individual. If we are working in the proper directions, the individual can perform with their maximum efficiency, and we can get a maximum work done from the individuals. Direction facilitates the changes in the organization. Means, if we give the proper directions to the peoples, then if there is any changes in the organization structures or any organizational work, then that can be directed to the people, and according to that the changes can be done. The direction provides the stability and balance in the organization. With the help of direction, we can get a stability and a balanced work in the organization. Then, the communication process is the most important part in the growth of organization. The process by which a person transmits information to the managers or to another persons. So, in the communication, we are having two persons. One is the sender and second is the receiver. The sender person transmits the information to the receiver, and according to that information, the receivers are working. Then after the work is completed, the receiver will give the feedback to the sender. So this communication process is the two-way process by which the growth of organization can be achieved. The purpose of communication process is to convey the orders, instructions, and the information. So, with the help of communication, we can give the orders to the subordinates, we can give the instructions for the working with the employees, and we can share the various informations in the organization. Then, the types of communication are formal communication and informal communication, or the verbal or non-verbal communication. So according to these types, we can take the communication process in the organization, and on which we can achieve our goals of the organization, and we can get a maximum benefit from the workers. Last is the motivation. And this is the most important part again, because without motivation or without any motive in our life, we cannot go to the success point. So the motivation is the important part. It is a force that inspires a person at work to intensify his willingness to use the best of his capability for achievement of the specific objectives. It may be in the form of incentives like financial or non-financial, or it could be a positive or negative. Basically, motivation is directed towards the goals and prompt people to act. So this motivation is given to the workers in the working in the organization so that they can give their most of the efficiency in the working. So this can be achieved with the financial motivation or non-financial motivation. Financial motivation means we can give the bonus or we can give the commissions to the workers working in the organization. Or non-financial means such as appreciation for the work, or we can give their promotion for their work purpose. So this is the types of motivation by which we can motivate our workers working in the organization. Then the last function of management, that is controlling. Controlling means maintaining influence over the skillfully and usually to one advantage. It is a process of monitoring performance and taking action to ensure desired results. And it seems to be that the right things happen in the right way and the right time. So controlling, that means control over the working of the employees working in the organization. How they are working, or they are working in the right way or not, or they are working in the right time or not. Seeing all those things, it is known as a controlling. The controlling process is given over here. First one, establishing the standards, then measurement of actual performance, then comparison of actual performance with the standards, and corrective action if necessary. So this is the whole process of controlling. In the step one, the various standards are established. That means the rules and regulations are established in the organization. Then the workers working in the organization are checked for their actual performance according to the standards. Then the comparison is done in between the actual performance and the standards. And if there is any correction or any corrective action is there, then that is carried out if necessary. And for all this process, the feedbacks are taken from the employee. So this is the whole controlling process in the organization. So we have completed all the functions of management: planning, organizing, staffing, directing, and controlling. With the help of all these functions, the each and every organization is work for their smooth working and for achieving their goals and objectives. Thank you.